Pleasant morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. It's a brand new day, and today is a glorious and holy one. We thank God this Tuesday morning for his rich blessings in our lives, and we pray that God will continue to guide us in our devotions this morning. Our first hymn, our opening hymn rather, is hymn number 521, Have Thine Own Way, Lord. Have Thine Own Way.
Have Thine Own Way, Lord. Have Thine Own Way. Thou art the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me after Thy will. While I am waiting, yielded and still. Have Thine Own Way, Lord. Have Thine Own Way. Search me and try me, Master, today. Whiter than snow, Lord, wash me just now.
Continue in this morning's morning prayer on page 32 in our Books of Common Prayer and the pages following thereafter. To God be the glory, the only one who saves us through Jesus Christ our Lord, be the glory, majesty, authority, and power which he made before time began, now and forever. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Together. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Jubilate. O shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth, and serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pastures. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is a good God. His loving mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forevermore. Amen. At this point in time, we spend a moment with God in contemplation and in reflection as we ask God to forgive us of our sins. At this moment, we ask God to cleanse our hearts from all unrighteousness, as we present these things to him, of even which our consciousness are afraid. Let us pray. Have mercy upon us, most merciful God. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The psalm for today is Psalm 45. Psalm 45. My heart is stirring with a noble song. Let me recite what I have fashioned for the king. My tongue shall be the pen of the skilled writer. You are the fairest of men. Grace flows from your lips, because God has blessed you forever. Strap your sword upon your thigh, O mighty warrior, in your pride and in your majesty. Ride out and conquer in the cause of truth and for the sake of justice. Your right hand will always show you marvelous things. Your arrows are very sharp, O mighty warrior. The peoples are falling at your feet, and the king's enemies are losing heart. Your throne, O God, endures forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. You love righteousness and you hate iniquity. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows. All your garments are fragrant with myrrh, aloes, and cassia, and the music of strings from ivory palaces make you glad. King's daughters stand among the ladies of the court. On your right hand is the queen, adorned with the gold of Ophir. Hear, O daughter, consider and listen closely. Forget your people and your father's house. The king will have pleasure in your beauty. He is your master, therefore do him honor. The people of Tyre are here with a gift. The rich among the people seek your favor. Well, glorious is the princess as she enters. Her gown is clothed of gold. In embroidery apparel she is brought to the king, after the bridesmaids follow in procession. With joy and gladness they are brought and enter into the palace of the king. In place of fathers, O king, you shall have sons. You shall make them princes over all the earth. I will make your name to be remembered from one generation to another. Therefore, nations will praise you forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The first reading is taken from Joshua chapter 8, verses 1 to 22. Then the Lord said to Joshua, "Do not fear or be dismayed. Take all the fighting men with you and go up now to Ai. See, I have handed over to you the king and all his people, his city and his land. You shall do to Ai and its king as you did to Jericho and its king. Only its spoil and its livestock you may take as booty for yourselves. Set an ambush against the city behind it." So Joshua and all the fighting men set out to go up against Ai. Joshua chose 30,000 warriors and sent them out by night with the command, "You shall lie in ambush against the city behind it. Do not go very far from the city, but all of you stay alert. I and all the people who are with me will approach the city. When they come out against us, as before, we shall flee from them. They will come out after us until we have thrown them away from the city. For they will say, they are fleeing from us. Before, while we flee from them, you shall rise up from the ambush and seize the city. For the Lord your God will give it into your hand. And when you have taken the city, you shall set the city on fire, doing as the Lord has ordered. See, I have commanded you. So Joshua sent them out, and they went out to the place of the ambush, and lay between Bethel and Ai, to the west of Ai, where Joshua spent the night in the camp. In the morning, Joshua rose early, and mustered the people, and went up with the elders of Israel, before the people, to Ai. All the fighting men who were with him went up and drew near before the city and camped on the north side of the city with a ravine between them. Taking about 5,000 men, he set them in ambush between Bethel and Ai to the west of the city. So they stationed the forces, the main encampment, that the north of the city and the guard and its rear guard west of the city. But Joshua spent that night in his valley. When the king of Ai saw this, he and all his people, the inhabitants of the city, hurried out early in the morning to the meeting place facing Arabah to meet Israel in battle. But he did not know that there was an ambush against him behind the city. And Joshua and all Israel made a pretense of being beaten before them and fled in the direction of the wilderness. So all the people who were in the city were called together to pursue them. As they pursued Joshua, they were drawn away from the city. There was not a man left who did not go out after Israel. They left the city open and pursued Israel. Then the Lord said to Joshua, "Stretch out the sword that is in your hand towards Ai, for I will give it into your hand." And Joshua stretched out the sword that was in his hand toward the city. As soon as he stretched out his hand, the troops in ambush rose quickly out of their place and rushed forward. They entered the city and took it, and at once they set the city on fire. So when the men of Ai looked back, the smoke of the city was rising to the sky. They had no power to flee this way or that, for the people who fled to the wilderness turned back against the pursuers. When Joshua and all Israel saw that the ambush had taken the city and the smoke of the city was rising, then they turned back and shot down the men of Ai. And the others came out of the city against them, so they were surrounded by Israel, some on one side and some on another. And Israel struck them down until no one was left, survived, or escaped. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, and born of the house of your servant David. Through your prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you, all the days of our lives. And to you, child, shall be called a prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation, by the forgiveness of their sins and the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The second reading. A reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 26, verses 47 to 56. Matthew chapter 26, verses 47 to 56. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived with him, with a large crowd, with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I kiss is the man, and arrest him." At once he came up to Jesus, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you are here to do." Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. Suddenly one of those with Jesus put his hand on his sword and drew it, and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. And Jesus said to him, "Put your sword back into its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But then would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say it must happen in this way?" At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. My dear brothers and sisters, may the words of my lips not be mine. May the message of my heart be that of God, and may the inspiration of the Holy Spirit guide my thoughts with you at this point. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But then, how would the scriptures be fulfilled? My dear friends in Christ, I pray to you and I thank you for joining me once again in this morning's service. This morning's message and scripture reading is familiar. It is one where we have the opportunity to examine ourselves. We see the scripture here take place where Judas is part of the whole thing, the whole passage which was read from Matthew chapter 26, verses 47 to 56, where Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss. But it was more than that. This scripture, it highlights the beginning of a series of chain of events. Or rather, the continuation. Prior to this, we would have had the Last Supper of Jesus Christ, where he would have instituted the communion as we know it today, the Holy Eucharist. So now we have another opportunity where we saw another phase into this aspect of our redemption from Jesus Christ, where Jesus began the journey of sacrifice of his life for himself to us. We see Judas enter with the chief priests and the others who wanted to arrest Christ. Unlike today, not everybody will know who Jesus was. There was no Instagram. There was no internet. There was no Twitter. There wasn't Facebook. There wasn't WhatsApp stories. There wasn't WhatsApp. So they had to be certain about who it is that they were going to arrest. They had to make sure they got the right man. And in so doing, they chose, they got the opportunity, they got Judas, whom they paid 30 pieces of silver to betray Jesus Christ. And Judas, as outlined to us here, had identified that, here's what, I would show you the man by, and the one whom I kiss is he. So Judas went out with all of them, the chief priests and their slaves and everyone else, and the soldiers, and they went with clubs and swords to arrest Jesus. One can only assume that they expected Jesus to rebel against them just because they judged Jesus by their own standards. So they expected that, here's what, we are going to arrest this man. So we want to come and we had to make sure we protect ourselves. And then upon reaching, Judas kissed Jesus. Rabbi, he gave him a kiss. A peaceful sign. But this was no ordinary kiss. This was no ordinary kiss. This was a kiss of death. This was a kiss of betrayal. And Judas, in so doing, identified and handed over Jesus to the chief priests and scribes. Now, something else happened here which is very ironic. Because the chief priests and the soldiers and the scribes and their slaves came weaponized to attack because they thought that they would be attacked. And unknowing to them, one of Jesus' disciples drew their swords and cut off the ear of the slave of one of the chief priests. And could you imagine how they would have felt to see that Jesus took up this ear and healed that slave? Can you imagine the remorse that slave would have felt? The pity, the guilt that he would have felt? Can you imagine how Judas himself, when he witnessed that, how he would have felt? Now, many people argue and they paint Judas in many ways. But I am no person to judge Judas. Because as Jesus put it in his own, in his scripture here, in verse 54, but how then would the scripture be fulfilled? Judas's role was important. No, I am not saying to betray your friends in Christ, but Jesus Christ came to die for you and for me. And in so doing, when Judas had to betray Jesus, he did it because he had to and he had no choice. But Jesus willingly, however, knowing all of these things were to happen, did not depart from it, for he drank the cup for which God had given him, because he came on this earth for that purpose. Everybody he healed was for a purpose. Every person he raised from the dead was for a purpose. Everybody he fed with his miracles was for a purpose. Every teaching he gave to his disciples was for a purpose. And this time, when he had to be arrested in the way he did, was the purpose to fulfill the scripture that spoke about his arrest, his eventual beating and flogging, and his crucifixion on the cross, his death, and more importantly, his rising from the dead. Jesus had to die to save you and to save me, so that we would not have to go through what we are continually giving up. But my friends in Christ, are we operating like bandits? Are we stealing from God's kingdom? Are we doing what we are not supposed to do? Are we giving of giving what we are not supposed to give? Are we stealing from God's people and encouraging them to do wrong? Are we doing what is not supposed to happen? My dear friends in Christ, Jesus Christ loves you. We cannot give up on God. We cannot give up on Jesus. We cannot give up on what God has sent us out to do. Are we running away from our purpose? Are we running away from the destiny that God has given us to do? Are we running away from talking to our neighbor about the gospel? Are we running away from teaching our children what is wrong and what is right? Are we ready to accept what God has given us to do? Are we ashamed to say to God, be the glory for great things he has done, and to share this message of promise and hope in the cross to others? We cannot exist without you, God. And we cannot exist, our sins cannot be saved, cannot be forgiven, unless it's done through God. So my dear friends in Christ, let us give of ourselves, and let us give God the honor and the glory for the things that he continues to do in our lives. My dear friends, to God be the glory, for his sacrifice was a great thing he has done. All the healing stream flows from Calvary's mountain. In the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. In our intercessions, we pray for the Right Reverend Claude Berkeley, Diocesan Bishop of the Anglican Church of Trinidad and Tobago. We pray for all retired bishops and all clergies in all aspects of God's kingdom, serving the glory of God. In particular, in our parish of St. Mary, we remember the Right. In our parish of St. Mary, we remember the Reverend Anderson Maxwell, priest in charge. We also remember the Reverend Titus Akbarali, also priest. We also remember deacons Theodore Finley, Rodrin Fanfare, and Daniel Pontiflet Andre. We pray that God's grace will be upon each and every one of them, and God will bless and keep their families and keep them safe. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We use form A in our intercessions. Lord, reveal your love among us, that you may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Our collect is from Proper 11, found on page 176. Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, you know our necessities before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Have compassion on our weakness and mercifully give us those things which for our unworthiness we dare not, and for our blindness we cannot ask. Through the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Into your hands, Lord, we commend ourselves this day. Let our presence be with us to its close. Strengthen us, Heavenly Father, to remember that in whatever good work we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit, that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it, may gladly perform it. To the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord and give thanks to God. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, the service has ended. May God richly bless you and keep you, and guide your thoughts and your hearts. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forevermore. Amen. Faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. Great is thy faithfulness.